Drew 2. Welcome to Hashtag Religion Week TV. I'm your host, Drew L. Murray, and here we sip a lot of tea with no shade, talking everything up the Yahweh. Enjoy the video. Tea, no shade. Grow the hell up spiritually. The Bible says you want milk. I say the one at the hospital, you ain't get the one we came home with. You suck them little bottles that you came at the hospital. And if you breastfeed, you still have the hair attached to your mama titty. And wet behind the ear, the streets used to say when I was in the streets. You're sucking milk from your mama titty and you're wet behind your ears. How do people have to talk, oh, these thousand days, everything gonna be all right? The Bible tells you the kingdom of heaven suffer violence and the violence take it by force. Them violent people out there in the Romans, they come out, hang their head out and say, God bless you. Them some violent people over there. The queen, she pretend to be innocent. They had to be violent in order to sell you into slavery. We are the kingdom of heaven, people. Wake up. Now, yeah, I like to get a little aggressive right there because the Bible says, be angry and sin not and let not the sun go down on your wrath. It's still 1 o'clock. Bet you by the time I go to bed tonight, nothing but sweet sleep and peaceful dreams for me. But when you talking, I imagine Jonah running the other way, because you people make somebody want to run the other way. But thank God I'm rooted and planted in the word of God, and it's rooted and planted in me, because I'm not running nowhere. Move over, Oprah. Nobody got to pretend to be one way in the front and then in behind closed doors act another way, Oprah. That's what Whitney Houston did. Y'all killed that woman, because if she could have just been a cussing, smoking, a Bobby Brown loving person and didn't have to pretend to be a white woman and sell records to a white industry, she'd still probably be alive today. And with that being said, y'all all on blast about all this nonsense going on out here. You a destructive wave of highly compressed air spreading outward from an explosion. Yes, you are. I read your posts. I see what y'all say. And y'all ain't speaking no life into nobody. Words, according to the book of Deuteronomy 30:19, have power. Life and death are set before you this day. Choose life, choose death. There's power in there's life and death in the power of the tongue. So I'm going to use my tongue, because out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speak, to exhort, encourage, and comfort you people. By the time we're done with this talk, we will not be buried here today, okay, which is almost a few more minutes. We will not be buried here today, okay? Oh, it's time to rise up. Maybe God have me, Jedediah, and other people out here breaking this down for you and trying to open your eyes so that you can be woke, because even some of the people in the campaign woke is still asleep. Everybody would be out here spitting the same stuff, having the same mindset. And again, like I was posting yesterday, where does your mindset, you know? Everybody worrying about everything else, but you got to know where your mindset's. Where does your mindset? What is your mindset? You understand what I'm saying? Come on. Your mindset and then Kanika Jenkins, so Kanika Jenkins is going to be your all and be all. Your mindset in Christ is going to be your all and be all, all right? And I have to stop saying Christ, because Christ is just a creation of Yahweh. He is a messenger of Yahweh. The Bible says in the book of Malachi, when he who was the last prophet spoke on Christ, basically says that he's a refiner. He gonna come. This is prophesied to turn the hearts of the fathers back to the children and the hearts of the children back to the father. And y'all make it all out with Christ out here, this, that, and the third. Yeah, he performed miracles. He wants to turn your hearts back to the father. That's what he came to do, to turn your heart back to the father. And y'all don't even want to follow your Jesus dipped in the blood of back to the father. Because even Jesus said, if you want to call him Jesus, I didn't come to do my will, not thy will, but the Lord's will be done. Everything came out Christ's mouth, Jesus' mouth, was, I came to do the will of my Father, and y'all want to do the will of Jesus. And wonder why you struggle as a believer, as a Christian. And you wonder why some Christians are alive physically, but dead spiritually. Now the second definition. A strong gust of wind or air, having no power. The definition is just a strong gust of wind or air. A lot of that. Y'all just out there woofing, selling woof tickets. Woof, 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 woof. Trying to intimidate people with your posts and with your videos and with this and what you say. Having no power to change nobody's life or make anybody get off of Facebook or YouTube. People are still standing here speaking and living their truth. And let me tell you, if Jesus or Christ can't heal you or have you heal yourself, because many of the afflictions, your afflictions and your mess and all that, who gonna deliver you? Who's gonna do that? You're supposed to have the power of the Holy Spirit working within you, people, to pray a headache away, a backache of this. Matter of fact, just say, I am healed by his stripes. He was wounded for my transgressions. He was bruised for my iniquities. The chastisement of his peace is upon me, and I'm healed by his stripes. Y'all don't want to confess this stuff out your mouth. Y'all want to confess everything out your mouth to keep you enslaved. Okay? So it's like, you know, you have to win a soul for Christ when it may be strong. But there are some strong people in the world who are strong but powerless. When I say this second definition, strong gust of wind or air, there's some powerful people. When I looked up the word potentate, because it's in the Bible, referred it to your Jesus, and I told you he got triplets. He's a triplet set of twins. Zeus, Jesus, and the Pope. Whichever one you want to put the face there of. They triplets. It said powerful, potentate. It mentioned Jesus, it mentioned Zeus, and it mentioned the Pope. They all want to be the high priest. Well, they do. Christ is the high priest and have the power. But these three triplets over here impersonating Christ wants the power. And you people out there following that doctrine is powerless. You don't have no power. If you did, you'd be going to grave cemeteries. You'd be at the hospitals healing your sick loved ones. You'd be at the White House again, just praying down, letting judgment rain down from heaven, like Martin Luther King said, okay? But you don't have that kind of power. And the church, no, the church goes first, and then the church goes before thee, and other stuff was to come after. But they say keep the church and state separate so Donald Trump can make rules. Like when he groping women out here, he's under that law where they don't get prosecuted or punished. But if he's under the judgment of the law of God, that's wickedness in this, according to this Bible. So keep that, keep it. We got rules over here. Y'all follow God's rules over there. Mm-hmm. The church better wake up. Wake up, church. And that's why so many people is powerless when it comes to KJ. I mean, you can't get off it. You can't stop making videos. You can't stop watching it. You can't stop talking about it. You can't stop. If it's getting you coins and it's become your life, come up with some new stuff, okay? Stop going over them dead hotel pictures, XYZ, whether you believe she's still living or dead. Get over it. You're powerless. Use a strong wind or air. If you get coins behind it again, people know how to do that over there on YouTube. But any good money, all money ain't good money. And like I put a post on there, yeah, blessings is not a manipulation. Look at the word manipulation. Man-eye pollution. Manipulation. 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 Man-eye pollution. A polluted-ass man or woman out here raping and robbing and seducing God's people for the money in church and on YouTube. Get some credibility with you folks. Alright, I'm making this KJ video, and I made another one, but it's in correlation to Christ. Because KJ and Christ cannot die two different ways. And I say this to say this, and then we're going to have to wrap it up. Kanika allegedly was killed by people. They say the white Jewish people in the Crown Plaza for her organs in that funeral home guy. And they said her friend set her up drug related. They say her mama got her hiding out somewhere. They say she's still alive. They say Jesus died on the cross. They said he hung from a tree. Some say people was trying to kill him before he got hung on the cross, like the Pharisees. Read your Bible. And some of you believe he's risen with the right hand of the Father, and some of you think he's dead, and his body is hidden under the Vatican over there with Peter, who's crucified upside down. Now, I believe in the resurrection. He's somewhere because his Holy Spirit dwells in me. All I know, Christ said, I have to leave you, and when I go, I will send you from God, from Yahweh, the Holy Spirit, the Comforter, and the Spirit of truth. And the Bible says that the Spirit in us bears witness with the Spirit in heaven to bear all records of accounts and truth of Christ and God and his plan and purpose for people. And y'all running around here trying to catch the Holy Ghost and trying to, the purpose and plan for God's life. And it's just to be a son and daughter, stop being disobedient, turn back to the Father, accept the true calling as the children of Israel and God's chosen people, and tell them white people who did this to you to kiss your ass and let you live your life. You out there begging for reparation. Hell, I want repatriation. That's to go live in Israel where I came from. How about that? Cast me outside on a good day. I don't fight. I tell people, I wrote a song, Leave Your Weapons Home. This is called The Peace Train. When you get on board, leave your weapons home. We don't need no weapons. No, it says, when you get on board, leave your weapons home. All you need is faith and words alone to fight these battles I'm out here fighting. And if you haven't learned, dipped in the blood of Jesus, how to fight spiritual warfare yet, and that's just speaking the word of God, and that's why he said guard it in your heart, you're lost. They call you a lost sheep of Israel for the reason. For a reason. You're lost. Now, definition 3 says, blow up, explode, break apart, all that good stuff. You is just out here blowing up stuff, breaking apart stuff, getting mad at people, selling people out on every social media platform there is, going in on everybody. Let me get through these pages. Hey, we got about 7 more left. Going in on everybody. Somebody come on speaking like me, you want to just immediately jump out at them. Somebody like Oprah go to the White House, you want to praise her. Steve went to the White House. Kanye, all these people Donald Trump trying to seduce to the White House to control the masses with Sue saying, it's going to be all right. It's going to be this. Knowing damn well it's not. Y'all wake up. It's not. It is not. It's not. It's not. It's not. And y'all out here putting these posts and getting mad at people for no reason, clapping at people. And let me tell you something. The best clap back is the word of God. If you know the word of God, and you know the word of God, you don't beat nobody over the head with the word of God. But God says, cast not away your confidence. Jesus had to cast demons out of people. Jesus had to deal with disrespectful people. Jesus had to deal with people who tried to kill him. You think everything was, ooh, I love you, and he loved everybody, when the man said, I meant to say Christ. Excuse me. When Christ said, but see, we go back and forth. It's hard to change their names, but Christ know who I'm talking about. When he said all this stuff, but when Christ said, I didn't come, he said in the Garden of Gethsemane, he said, Lord, thine will be done, not my will. Thine will be done, Lord, not my will. Jesus had to clap back at people, y'all. He told Pontius Pilate, who marveled at the fact that he gonna say, you the King of Kings. Christ said, I love my accent when I do it in Jamaican. Are you set out mine? He said, they say that of me, or do they say that of you? You think he ran around here and love, 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 love everything? He said, Christ said, they hate me. The world gonna hate you. And if you run around here looking for everybody to love you, Christians, you's dead wrong. That God and Christ don't love everybody. If that was the case, He would never took Abraham from the land of Ur, who was a Chaldean, made some Hebrew Jewish people out of him. No, again, you just didn't want to call his name Judah, so he called himself you. And then, like I said, even his brothers, Reuben, Simeon, Asher, Gad, none of them called themselves Jew. That was just his nickname, a little young guy's nickname. And all his tribe grew up being a Jew. And that's the tribe that Christ sprang out of. Now, did Christ spring out? Or did Christ was born of a Virgin Mary? You ask God to witness that in your Holy Spirit and move on with it. Because I'm still asking God, we debating about that one. Not that I debate with the Lord, but we talk. Like, God, hold up. They told us he's a baby, Virgin Mary, born of a virgin. But you say he sprang out. And Melchizedek, if he's after the order of Melchizedek, Melchizedek sprang out, right? Because he had no mother, no father, no descendants. He had no beginning of days, nor ending of life. And if Christ is like Melchizedek, God, please let me know if it's a Virgin Mary. Because remember, they want you to glorify, the Roman Catholic Church wants you to glorify all this stuff. That's not your true condition and your true heritage is. Do the research on a man named Eleazar, and he'll let you know what repping the children of Israel is all about, okay? Because the Athenian senators in the book of 2 Maccabees, chapter 6, you're like, well, where that's at in my Bible? They took it out. Get online and look up 2 Maccabees, chapter 6, and Eleazar stood up against the Grecian Roman Empire then. Judas Maccabee, he's another one. You read about him, because that's really who he fought the revolt. And that menorah they light every September, coming Yom Kippur and all that stuff, those are your holidays, people. The black man, Judas Maccabees, a children of Israel, he might have been from the tribe of Judah, so you could probably call him a U. I know us black people are from Judah. We are Judans. We are Judah people. We are the descendants of Judah. Well, I wonder why they ain't never had no last name either. We just call him Judah. We just call him Abraham. Abraham, whoa. Abraham, God. Abraham, what's your last name, Abraham? But you see how we come over here and we have last names and all that now? There's no last names in the Bible and stuff like that. And if it was, the 1611 Bible may have more information than this modern day Bible, because they keep trying to translate it out to keep you from getting the original truth and the meat and potatoes of it all. Okay, so now, definition four. Again, I said the greatest clapback is with the Word of God. It really is. Because the Word of God is a two-edged sword. You're cutting them down on one side, but it prunes you up on the other side. So you don't leave nobody dead, hurting with the Word. You're building them back up at the same time. Definition four is to, like, make a loud noise. Everybody out there making a loud noise with your post about your personal business, who you slept with, did this with, had an argument with, had a beef with. Who did you educate? I always say education is free, but not the pain you're going through. That pain, I've been through pain. I know. I speak from pure experience, y'all. At 50 years old, I've been through a lot. By the grace of God, he always tell me, not because you had to go through it. You went through it to help somebody else to go through it. And that's the selfishness of you. You've been through stuff, but you don't want to share your testimony and overcome the devil or the enemy or the wickedness of the world with your testimony. And it said the blood of Jesus. But again, the blood of Jesus is only supposed to be on your doorpost so that death can pass over your house. You understand what I'm saying? And you ain't supposed to be dipped in it. Because if you anything like me, you'd be so dipped in it, you don't feel the presence of Yahweh. And you not really walking out your purpose and your plan. And you just out there making a loud noise for no reason. Okay. Anyway, here we go. So all that nonsense is just loud, but who has it saved? And guys, I want to let you know the Holy Spirit whispers. And with all that loud noise going on out there that you playing over here on Facebook, playing over there on YouTube, you ain't hearing the Holy Spirit speak to you. He might have been told you to stop doing what you're doing. Stop living like this. The Bible says he stands at the door of your heart, Christ does, and knock. And if any man open, he'll come in and sup with you. That doesn't mean you have to live a dull, mundane life. You see me, I'm still here having a good time. Got laughter in me. You get more joy, more freedom, more peace. Yes, yes. When you passionate about something, you raise your voice a little bit. When you passionate about something, you give it your all. And you talk with confidence. And you talk like you know what you're talking about. You cannot go out here playing patty cake with the devil or anybody thereof. Because the Bible say he got a nephew, the son of perdition. He got children. You don't know. Call them the children of disobedience and the children of wrath. But you out here talking about Jesus love everybody. Okay. All right. Y'all over in all social media, every platform, y'all just making noise. But the kingdom of heaven suffers violence. And the violence take it by force. You with your nonsense, because there's some wickedness y'all be putting in your posts. Y'all be putting in your videos, coming at each other, trying to cut throat. Y'all steady killing your own community. And until you stop doing it, H&M ain't gonna stop doing it. The White House ain't gonna stop doing it. The house niggas ain't gonna stop doing it. Understand me? And that H&M stands for hatred and malice within you and your communities. That's just spewing out. Like, if you ever did the research on your community, it's called the blight condition. That's how some of your hearts is, okay? You gotta stop, man. You gotta stop, woman. You gotta stop, children. Don't keep living by how these people told you you're supposed to live. Find out your truth. I heard somebody post on Facebook yesterday, well, your truth is that, and I'm just not going to bother with you. Honey, let me tell you something. And I said, I'd be doing God a disservice if I block you and delete you, especially if you're a lost soul. I'm looking at life differently, okay? I'm not mad at nobody that's coming at me sideways, coming at Jedediah, coming at Planet of the Fates. Anybody out here speaking a real truth about the Kanika Jenkins case or about Christ in situations going on in our black community, I stand with y'all, man. Hate on us because they hated Christ. They hate God. And just like people posting all that stuff, oh, I see how you move. I'm moving good. If everybody else in our community start moving like this and had a voice, but didn't want to use violence and go out there and break up other people's stuff, because I still believe in, this is my stuff. You ain't got, H&M do have insurance. H&M still going to be open. H&M ain't hiring no damn black people no more. You just killing us. And all them people like Jedediah saying, like, I back up. You need lawyers. Your mama's embarrassed now. You was on the news. And it's another strike against us black folks. Because when they talk about being monkeys, watermelons, chickens, and apes, homo sapiens, some of y'all out there do look like a little monkey, but I'm not here to judge. But every time you present it with a situation like H&M coming out and doing something like that, or the president tweeting and saying what he do, you respond to it like a damn monkey. You respond to it like a nigga. You respond to it like these white people who gave you this tradition and culture of Christianity want you to. You can't keep responding to this. And that's that. I'm telling you, you cannot. You know, it says right here, you too busy and enslaved by cults, flags, psyops, and the Roman Emperor's control with the Greek churches, because Greek, the church means ecclesia. Ecclesia, call that one. It's a Greek word. You ain't Greek. I'm a black woman trying to gotta read this Bible and look up Greek definitions when the name Jesus says it's an original name from Greek, but it's after a rendition of a Hebrew name, Yeshua. That right there is enough for me to call Jesus Yeshua, because Yeshua is the Christ. How about that? Connect the dots. But you steady trying to connect these videos on Facebook. You steady trying to connect these videos over here on Facebook. I mean YouTube. To disprove somebody's theory about Kanika on blast. And you steady trying to post and click up over here on Facebook trying to disprove somebody's belief and truth in what they're saying about what I'm saying and speaking like I'm speaking to discredit us. Y'all gotta stop that, man. Stop it, man. Stop it, stop it, stop it. Yes, this is one of my heated topics, yo, because you get tired of seeing your brothers and sisters behave so. In the church, out of the church, especially on social media. Now, you have let in life, you know, to air out, you're letting life to air out your dirty laundry amongst one another. You're fighting, you're using this ammunition to destroy other people. And I said for no reason, but the devil don't need a reason to come at you if you spiritually sound, walking with sound mind, power, love, and a sound mind that Christ gives people through the Holy Spirit. You don't like that. And you come at people. I say you in people's past, digging up their past, like the grave master of the cemetery. Give me a break. I'm real with my truth. I don't have nothing in my past because my past is what set me free. Not knowing this truth right here is what caused my past to be like it is. Knowing my truth now, I can share my past just like Christians. You should be told in church to know your past. They tell you don't look in the past because they don't want you to know this truth. They deceiving you in church because they know if you weak and broken hearted still and have blind eyes and deaf ears, they can get your money. That's why the pastor is growing and not you. And just like you're led to hate one another so that they divide and conquer. Because when you're divided, somebody's being conquered. Like the people in Libya, you give nothing damn about being sold for $400. Okay? Like the women Donald Trump is groping, his whole cabinet about to sink and fall, go under. Whole cabinet, the whole cruise line in D.C. pretty much done groped the woman, okay? And y'all okay with this? You have nothing better to do but fight over Kanika Jenkins and over Jesus. And like with Kanika and Christ, the devil will be left standing greater in number, because when the people who gave you the religion of Christianity after Christ, it was never called Christianity. Christ never walked in the temple. Christ never, walked in the church. He went in the temple and turned over the tables and pretty much went off on them. But he never walked in the church. And see, some of your churches suffer violence with guns, with people coming in and killing up your churches. I know you believe, but sometimes when you believe in something that ain't true and that's not your culture and doesn't work for your community, It doesn't work for you. And even though we go to church, you never seen nobody walk in the temple of the Lord and shoot up the temple. But these churches, which is really called the synagogue of Satan in the back of the book of the Revelations there, is being defeated left and right. And people, you gotta, us black Christians, us people, us believers, like I said, I don't really identify with Christ, because the Bible says, be not deceived, God shall not be mocked. And when you put Christians and Christianity on a man's name, remember they only had one name. He only walked with the name Christ. So we don't need Paul telling us that we Christians. We followed the way back then. But to divide us with Christ, we're still being conquered today with Kanika Jenkins. And I hope you hear what I'm saying. They divided us with Christ way back when. Even on the plantation, some was divided. House nigga, field niggas, light skin, dark skin brothers, this, that, and the third. And we're still divided today. And this is how, whether you call it the body of Christ or church or the kingdom of Yahweh, this is how we suffer violence and you don't give a damn. All you care about is your baby Jesus, who is my king of righteousness and my king of shalom. And all you care about is Kanika Jenkins, who one way or another if she's dead or if she's alive. Like, I did a video that says, New Kanika Jenkins in Christ Outlook. R-I-H or Lord have mercy. It's going to be one or the other. You can't stay consumed in it and let it overtake you like that, okay? Now, to begin with the drive is, now to begin to drive this nail in the coffin with this, with the nails on the outside. We're not in the coffin, guys. I told you, nothing will ever bury us when you speak your truth and when you speak it with confidence and when you speak it with revelation coming from the Lord. You will never, ever get buried again by anything in this world. So, to drive this nail into the coffin with us on the outside of it, because, like I have been saying all along, if you talk it up to Yahweh, nothing can bury you. He is going to reveal all truth to you if you worship him in spirit and in truth. You won't be out here fishing, trying to make these Kanika Jenkins videos, trying to fish, trying to get people to follow you, deceiving people like the devil. And you